Hi, my name is Oge Okonkwo, and I'm just here with a group of young people who are also tired of this Okada and Keke ban. We really don't think the government thought this over. This is putting the cart before the horse. They put the cart before the horse on this, and I really think they need to, or we think that they need to reconsider this. They set up a policy and then brought the alternative after setting up the policy, and the alternative is not even effective. These buses that they are bringing, they don't enter the street corners that kekes and bikes pass. So even forget Nigeria as a whole, women alone, like already I've seen so many reports of women who have been raped on their way to work because they had to like walk the streets rather than use an Okada. And this is just like one of the many disadvantages and chain reactions that this ban has caused. And we really think that they need to reconsider, even if we understand that, fine, there may be some safety issues, but fine, regulate them and don't just take them away. This is a major means of transportation for millions of people in Lagos, and it doesn't make sense to just take them away. People have been walking, and it's not funny anymore. We can't continue to walk. We can't continue to adapt. Adapting is not living. Like, this is survival. This is not living. So we can't keep going like this. If they're saying that the reason why they are banning keke and okada is because of security concerns, then now that you've displaced so many people from employment, what do you think would happen? Now they are snatching bags. People are getting they're snatching bags from roads. People are getting stabbed. They are entering one chance, exactly. So now that people don't have bikes and okada, they have to be entering private cars, and those private cars are one chance most times. So, like, if you're saying it's a security concern, you've taken us back how many more steps? You've taken us back so many more steps. So exactly, fix the problem first.